shocking and controversial, you know, it gets twice the press.
That's big news. But what are you going to do? You're selling product to an under 18 audience, you know? You got to have some sort of rules to govern it. Because the record companies are signing all this. I mean, there's some questionable acts out there writing songs about questionable acts, you know? Who's protecting the kids?
And if we can't get into a Kmart or a Sears, you know, those kids don't go there anyway.
I mean, what's the record that gets put behind the little white cardboard piece like Penthouse, you know? Which record is that one? And what's the record that gets to stay out like, you know, New Homes and Gardens, you know? Which record is that? And which record is the other one, you know?
What you can't get.
And who gets to decide that? That's where people are so pissed off about this stickering of the records. You know, who is deciding? Who gets to decide, you know, the quality control standard that's going to be mandated to everyone? And that's what pisses everyone off, because the people should be able to decide that, not, you know, Tipper Gore.
Really?
Soundgarden shared a Grammy nomination with us this year, which was very exciting to see two bands from, I mean, we were elated just to be in the thing, you know, to get the nomination, but to see another Seattle band as well, you know, was a great boost for the area. And there must be basements crammed full of bands in the area.
Form, it deals with people's, young people's decisions at an early age on which sort of road they're going to take. They're at that proverbial fork. And are they going to take the tried and true method of studying hard and getting an education and then going for that good paying job with security? Or are they going to be risky and not educate themselves and end up selling dope on the street or something related to crime? And it just looks at that point in the road where people have to decide which way they're going to go.
So we've decided to cancel the long-running series of Nicky Returns, you know, the Halloween process of releasing, you know, second and third versions of this story. The concept approach that we did last time, I think we were very happy with the end result and decided that it would be best for us to try something new.
This album, in contrast to that, is pulled in, and it's sort of a introspective look at sort of the personal side of us.
I don't think there is anything threatening about what we talk about in our records. Really, it's very constructive criticism.
I've got this theory, see. I think the media and companies that sell products have made it seems so important for us to have merchandise, goods. We've got to have that new Toyota, you know, that the family is disintegrated because it takes two parents to earn the kind of money it takes to buy all this shit that we really don't need. So there's nobody home to supervise and to see, you know, how the kids are doing. And you know, that's the first step in disintegration right there. Economics is the new warfare. We can't blow each other to hell anymore with nuclear bombs. People realize that. So the only way we can fight each other is through economics.
We have role models in very high places that are doing questionable activity, and no one is getting back to questions, you know, no one is asking why. How am I being manipulated? You know, is it either by drugs? Is it by other people telling me and shaping my future for me? Is it me deciding, you know, what the possibilities are for me?
By way of comparison, the federal government spent $24 million.
Is the system always right? Is it right just because you exist in it? You know, when you watch the pollution charts, Michael mentioned this maybe the other day, you know, they say, well, it was better than last year. You know, and it's a crack up that is how people you know, statistically judge, you know, our damage to the planet. It's not the fact that the thing's been around for billions, you know, millions of years. It's that in the last century we have, you know, wasted and raped this place.
You can reach a lot of people with music that don't watch the news or don't read the papers, you know. You can get the same ideas across. So, and you got video now to support it.
It's a number 7 on the Billboard chart. They passed through New York City recently, and we took them out for an Indian lunch to see how they're holding up under all this sudden success.
After 8 years together, Queensryche's concept-heavy 1988 album Operation Mindcrime brought the Seattle-based group widespread acceptance. But with their newest LP, Empire, Queensryche abandoned the storyline approach for something altogether different.
You know, we just decided, okay, well, let's, you know, let's not continue the concept. That would cheapen the original idea. Let's go totally different, and that's what we did. You know, we just, you know, came up with a whole new batch of stuff that, you know, it still sounds very much like Queensryche, but it's just a different sort of offering.
That offering includes everything from sensitive songs to out-and-out headbangers to even some jazz-influenced tracks. It is obviously a mix that people like. Empire is already at number 7 after just 3 weeks on the Billboard album chart. That fast a break on the charts took even the band by surprise.
You know, we were excited to get the album out there, but to see this sort of, you know, reaction so quickly has left us all rather speechless.
The first single and title track from Empire contains a very contemporary message for young people.
It addresses the crack problem, which is, you know, particularly, you know, appealing, I guess, to young people because it's, you know, drugs you can sell, you know, make money quickly, and it's just, you know, trying to take a critical look at that problem, which happens in Seattle as well. You know, it's everywhere.
The band came up with one not-so-bright idea for the song, recording as sound effects a real-life drug deal going on in downtown Vancouver. As it turned out, that plan had some holes in it.
We were too conspicuous. Jeff was driving the van, you know, we pulled up downtown. I had this big headset on, this big long, you know, microphone with this big nose on the front of it, you know, and we pulled up, I had sunglasses on, you know, we pull up in this van next to this park, you know, there's all these pigeons around, these guys, and they're, you know, doing the dirty stuff, you know, and we pull up and I have this microphone out, you know, out the door, and I've got all these headphones on, and everybody just, they noticed us right away. I mean, they thought we were undercover cops. I'm surprised we didn't get shot, you know. In retrospect, it was probably a really stupid thing to do, but you see, we go to those extremes for our records, you know? This is what we live for, you know?
Top 10 album, Empire, dealt with some of the hard choices facing young people in a society built upon instant gratification.
Everyone wants things now. It's very hard to be patient and wait, you know, because everything, all the information now comes at you so quickly.
Concept that not all musicians found objectionable.
I don't see anything wrong with putting a sticker on there that says this record contains extremely profane lyrics. I don't think that that is a crime.
Hi, Michael and Chris here from Queensryche in the hot seat in Amarillo, Texas. And some combination of the band will probably be here tomorrow.
Who are you guys?
To talk to you guys.
You guys gotta get out of here. We're working
here.
With
the band.
Here. I don't
trying
care
to
who you
this video.
Are.
This is Def Leppard. We gotta go.
Who
pour
is
some sugar
get
on me.
This camera out of
see
here.
You later.
Get out of here.
Yeah.
Hi, this is Jeff Tate
and Eddie Jackson
from Queensryche, and this is The Hot Seat. We're here in Amarillo, Texas, getting started for our tour, and gosh, we're guest VJs, and if you got it tuned to MTV, you got to watch us. This is Living Color.
This is the video Cult of Personality.
Watch it.
Now.
Just a couple more weeks starting our Empire tour. We had a great show in Amarillo last night, and we're moving and coming to your town next.
We'll be back with more of The Hot Seat on MTV.
Ooh, ooh. Ouch, that's hot.
This is The Hot Seat from Amarillo, Texas. I'm Eddie Jackson.
I'm Jeff Tate from Queensryche, and we're going to show you a clip from our series of videos we've been making for our album Empire. This is the title track, and you know, I'm supposed to tell you what it's all about, but I haven't seen it in so long, I can't remember.
It's been a while, hasn't it?
We'll watch it too. This is Empire.
We're getting ready to go to commercial here, so, but don't switch the channel, okay? Because, well, what do you got to look forward to anyway? They're just going to show you a few more sets of commercials with scantily clad women undulating and dancing, trying to sell you something. So come back and keep an eye on us. We're Queensryche.
We'll be back with The Hot Seat in Amarillo, Texas. Next, we have Great White. You know, I think we're the only ones here, Jeff.
Hi, welcome back to The Hot Seat. I'm Jeff Tate.
And Eddie Jackson from Queensryche.
And we'll be back tomorrow.
We have Great White next with Call It Rock and Roll.
Adios.
Adios.
Here on MTV, it's Wednesday and we're in Amarillo, Texas. I'm Michael Wilson.
I'm Jeff Tate from Queensryche, and we're watching videos. That's what we're doing. And this next one is called Janie's Got a Gun by Aerosmith. Show for us, our show here in Texas for the Empire Tour.
Oh, anyway, we have music from AC/DC still to come, but first commercials, so stick around.
Back to The Hot Seat on MTV. I'm Jeff Tate.
And I'm Michael Wilson from the band Queensryche.
God, they got us working for a living here. We're getting ready to take our show to a town near you.
But first, here's the latest from AC/DC. Are you ready?
Where's this go?
Over there.
Well, we went the opposite way.
Like in the hot seat.
Hi, welcome back to the hot seat. I'm Jeff Tate.
And I'm Michael Wilton from Queensryche.
We're coming to you from beautiful Amarillo, Texas. We're kicking off our tour here, and we're going to be with you for the next couple of days showing you the hot spots of this lovely city.
So until tomorrow, there's a goodbye from Queensryche, and adios.
Adios, amigos, tequilas.
And we're going to leave you with the video that we did called that.
1988 LP, Mind Crime. How does this unusual group go about reproducing its studio sound on stage? Well, here's what Queensryche guitarist Michael Wilton had to tell us.
When we're in the studio, we don't care about, you know, can we play this live? Should we play it? We just go for it, and we find ways to figure it out to play it live. And, yeah, you know, we usually pull it off with great accuracy. And
they belong.
Various members of the bands that played the annual Monsters of Rock concert last weekend at Castle Donington outside of London. Over the years, several U.S. groups have found that playing this giant show has served to launch their careers in Europe. And two of this year's star acts, Queensryche and the Black Crowes, are hoping to be among them.
We sort of see it as a beginning platform to really establish ourselves in England and in Europe as well. We've done this last year our first headlining tour of England and Europe, and that's a real good way to let people see you in a close-up, intimate performance. And this way, playing Donington, is to reach the masses who normally probably wouldn't hear of you.
As far as Europe.
The special thing about Donington, we've been watching it from a distance from the States for quite a few years as our career has developed. And we've always wanted to come over and play in this festival. And we've been very patient. And here we are, 1991, and it's finally happening.
I'm Chris DeGarmo.
And I'm Michael Wilton from Queensryche.
And we are most pleased to be your hosts for tonight's, well, enlightening and entertaining segment that's been come to known as Headbangers Ball. Yes, we'll be bombarding you with videos for the next 3 hours. Videos that are mentally stimulating, culturally enriching, sonically devastating perspectives from the post-atomic generation. Yes, we're going to be putting the hammer down. I had to do that. Showing you videos from, well, who, Michael? Who are we?
Well, we got AC/DC, Judas Priest, and Anthrax, and plus debuts from Helix, Jet Boy, Black Sabbath, Stevie, and Primus.
And we'd also like you to look out for details on how to enter Judas Priest's Headbanger Boot Camp contest. Yes, that should prove to be very, very exciting, so enter it once you see the details. But right now, without further ado, let's rock, shall we? How about some Queensryche to start off with? This is Eyes of a Stranger.